If you've been watching the World Cup, you would know about the slight controversy between the officiating crew and Uruguay, between the Uruguay and Ghana game that took place yesterday morning. And so I'm here to review it with the mind of a player and an official. So here we go. This morning around 10 a.m., Uruguay and Ghana took place in a Group H match. Ghana needed one goal in order to win, and which means actually to advance into the next competition, if you will, which is the round of 16. And Uruguay needed three goals in order to advance into the round of 16. By the end of the match, Uruguay was winning 2-0. Until a Ghana defender fouled a Uruguay striker in the box, and referee Daniel Serbeit said no penalty. So I'll put a little video of the actual foul that took place in the box, and then we'll review it. So this is the foul that actually took place. Thankfully, so that technically is a penalty that should have been awarded for Uruguay. Instead, referee Daniel Serbeit said play on. Once again, Uruguay did need three goals in order to advance in the World Cup. Therefore, if they got awarded that PK, they probably would have gotten the three goals they need for Uruguay to be in. And what was it? I think it was... my mind's going blank now. Was it Cameroon? Yeah, Cameroon. Sorry, not Cameroon. I just checked. Ghana. My mind went blank for a second. So if Uruguay got in those three goals, Ghana would be out and Uruguay would be in. Instead, it is vice versa. Uruguay did not take that lightly, which Uruguay players were very feisty as the game progressed, and especially once the game ended. Once the game ended, as the referee Daniel Serbeit was going into the tunnel, the players were actually chasing after him and apparently attacked him verbally and physically. As you can see, as the referee is trying to walk into the tunnel, which is their locker room as well, the players are not letting go. They're chasing after him. They're blaming it on him. They wanted that PK. They wanted that win. Well, who wouldn't want that win? But is this behavior appropriate? Now, I'll do my review as a player and as an official as well, because I do understand both sides as well. There is no doubt about the fact that that was a PK, and the VAR definitely messed that one up for Uruguay. There's no doubt about the fact that Uruguay's loss is blamed on this referee. There is no doubt about the fact that this referee was completely in the wrong. But now that Uruguay players reacted that the way they did, now it shows you that both the referee and the players are in the wrong. You cannot act like that. You can't act like that. There's no way, as a player, and I'm a soccer player as well, I am currently in a league, you don't act like that. I'm a player. I understand the frustration. I understand they wanted that win. I understand how frustrating it is when the referee makes a bad call and does not want to hear your explanation. I understand the frustration. You don't act like that. That is not how you reason with someone. That is not how you get someone to understand your point of view. If the referee doesn't want to talk to you, I understand the frustration. He will hear it from FIFA later. Believe me, he'll hear it from FIFA later. There is no excuse for that. There is no excuse for missing that penalty. That was completely a penalty that he missed. Completely unacceptable that he missed that. And you cannot make that kind of mistake as a referee in the World Cup. In the World Cup, you cannot make a mistake like that. You can't. In the video I showed you, the defender is clearly hooking his leg onto the striker. That is a foul. That is a foul. There's no doubt about the fact that that is not a foul. In soccer or football, whichever one you say, that will always, always, always be a foul, no matter who the referee is, who's playing, what's going on at the time. That will always be a foul, no matter what. But there also is no excuse to act like that on the pitch. I'm all for debating with the referee. Referee makes a bad call. Whoa. Come on. And the referee's gonna do this. I know. I'm with it. Okay, he's gonna do this. He's gonna cut you off in that. But you do not put your hands on the officiating crew. If the officiating crew doesn't put his hands on you, you don't put your hands on them in return. That's not only just the rules of soccer, that's also just being human. If you just don't put your hands on someone, that's literally just it. Like, that's not right. You don't put your hands on someone, no matter how bad of a mistake they made. Now, are there other ways to come about this? Well, yes, Uruguay will most likely be debating with FIFA about this. Could this referee be banned from possible World Cups in the future? We don't know. There's always a possibility. And this referee is rather young as well, which would be very unfortunate if that's his career right there, where he, not being fired, but banned from World Cups in the future, or banned for the next 3-4 World Cups. You really don't know. But this situation is still young, where there are many different outcomes that could possibly be taking place here. But if I was FIFA right here, I personally... would not know what to do in this situation, as you can't take away Ghana's win right there. Well, even though Uruguay won, they still needed one more goal. You can't. It's a very hard situation to come about. It really is. But the referee was wrong, and those players that began following him into the tunnel was wrong. So the final remark here is both the officiating crew and the players 100% in the wrong. I understand the frustration. I really do. You're in the World Cup and you're going home before the round of 16 because of a bad call. That must be so frustrating. That must be so... You can't think of something else other than that. The fact that this game was costed because of someone's... So my camera did die for a little bit, but it's back up and charged. So I forgot what exactly I was saying before the video stopped. So I'll just start again. The fact that Uruguay's loss was just because of that, the referee's poor choice of decision, is infuriating. I get it, but that does not give you the right to put your hands on a referee or just anyone in that matter. And I think we can all agree on that. We really could. We all do stuff we don't mean when we're angry, especially when it comes to something you're really passionate about. But you really do. It's simple. Control yourself. It's not really... Control yourself. As a player who has had debates with referees before, as this is a very common thing. Like, referees make mistakes. As a player, I've debated, I've caused controversy with this, with a call. My teammates have caused controversy with a call. My team and I have argued calls before, but not once have I put my hands on an official, not once have my teammates or I put my hands on an official. It's wrong to do, it's not right. Another thing that happened was, The Uruguay
striker that was fouled, Cavani, actually not only put his hands on the referee, but also smashed the VAR screen with his fist. Just unacceptable. Really is unacceptable. The referee did give him a yellow card, which does apply. Even a lot of people were saying, well, why give the yellow card? It's not going to affect him because Uruguay and him and his team are already out. Well, that also applies to any match that Uruguay plays in the future. In my opinion, if I was this referee, I'd give him a red card for that. Smashing the VAR screen. What if that VAR screen is broken now? Like, honestly. There's not many stadiums in Qatar. What if tomorrow's game needs that VAR screen but it's broken? Come on. Use this a little bit. I understand. You're frustrated you lost, but when I lose, I'm frustrated. When a referee has determined my loss before, I'm frustrated. I'm furious. I get it, but okay. You can't do stuff like this. When searching up the referee's name, Daniel Serbeit, this is all over the news. This referee is German. He is 38 years old from Berlin, Germany. Rather tall at 6'3". So, I know that's irrelevant. I'm just giving you details on that. Many people actually don't pity Uruguay for this. I'm not sure why, but I actually do pity everybody but Cavani on the Uruguay team, as Cavani was the main one starting the trouble with the referee as he was going down the tunnel. Incident with the referee, Ghana and Uruguay, actually sparks people's minds and remembrance for the 2010 World Cup, where Ghana and Uruguay were in a match together and it went to PKs and Uruguay took the lead. And many people believe that the referee actually did this to give Ghana the chance of winning. This does show a bias toward Ghana away from Uruguay, which is absolutely 100% wrong. So I'll keep you guys updated through this situation. But let me know your opinion on this. It's actually a very big topic. So let me know your opinion on this. Even if you don't watch soccer, let me know what you think about this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.